It's always intimidating when you start with a blank sheet. I mean, I can't tell you how many times I've gone to start writing some article and I'm just looking at the blank page and I'm thinking, where do I start? Do you get that feeling sometimes, Durant, when you start with something new?
Yeah, it's hard. You have to kind of, psych yourself up. I mean, everyone has their own techniques for just getting moving on a project. Often you can just start with the things you know. Like, you're going to use a model view, some kind of controller thing. So like, what can you start adding? If it's a map, maybe you're talking about places. Just finding some place you can start and just start adding things, and then eventually like the questions will maybe just come. But yeah, staring at that blank sheet of paper, as you say, is definitely difficult.
Yeah, I would say too, kind of just pick one part of the project to figure out first. Whether it's the list view, whether you want to get the search box working, whether you want to get parts of the map working. I would pick one thing, kind of figure out bits and pieces of it, kind of put that part together. And also, don't hesitate to kind of step away from the big project and maybe start just like a little sample project where you're like, I'm really having a hard time figuring out how to sort or how to sort, stuff in my list, or how to get all my markers to have unique info windows. It's good practice to maybe just say, okay, I think I've done a lot on my project. I don't want to break what I have. Let me kind of write something up here and just sort of a little side project and see if I can get this functionality working, and then figure out how to apply it back to my architecture that I've designed here. I do that a lot myself. I mean, there's a lot of times where I'm working on a project and I'm like, I don't really can't figure out how to get like this navigation to like pop out right. So I kind of make like a little dummy site. I kind of play around with things. It's easy for me to do it that way because it's on a much smaller scale and I'm less worried about breaking a ton of stuff in the process. Or having to do like 100 git commits or something. It's definitely useful to like take a step back, look at sort of the smaller problems, and knock out some smaller things first.
This is the first project where students aren't really given anything. Like we give them, the knockout framework, but they don't really get any code to begin with. So all the projects before this, they were given some sort of template code or something to sort of work off of. And I think, just opening up your text editor to just a blank page can be a little daunting at first, especially for someone who's really new at this. What kind of advice would you give to somebody who's kind of faced with this blank page?
Well, first I'll tell you that as someone who's been coding for a long time, I still get writer's block when you first open up a blank page, right?
I do too.
Yeah,
I do too, yes.
It's not something that entirely goes away, but it is something you can be better at, right? So if you open up your text editor and there's nothing there, all right, so what do we know should be there? Well, we definitely need an HTML file. Without an HTML file, we got nothing, right? So you need an HTML file, you need all of the basic HTML boilerplate, right? Depending on your tools, you can actually even install plugins that'll just put all of the doc type HTML, HTML head, body, all that stuff in there for you. So that unblankifies the page a little bit, right? But still, effectively, you don't have any content, any stuff that you've put on the page, right? You also need to link up your CSS file, probably, unless you're making something as just kind of a proof of concept. You need a CSS file to style it. You also need a JavaScript file, at least one. You also have multiple JavaScript files. It just depends on how you want to organize your code. But then where do you go from there? And I suppose if I can tell you what I would do. I can't really tell, I can't speak for everyone, but what I would do is I would start by I wouldn't worry about styling first. I wouldn't worry about CSS or any of that stuff. I would just put some divs on the page that represent the different areas, right? We know we need a map. So I'd go look at the Google Maps API and see if I can figure that out. But actually, even before I do that, I would try and get an idea of how generally to get started with Knockout. So, I mean, I might even go to the Knockout homepage and look at their very basic examples and just get their examples working, right? Mm-hmm. Even though I don't necessarily need a text box that says hello world with an input box that says the same thing and you can change them. I may not need that, but it gets something on the screen. And once you have something on the screen, you can be like, oh, that's right. Okay, I've got observables. I've got data binding, a data bind to connect things up. All right, now my memory is jogged. I'm ready to move forward. So I want to put a list. All right, so what could I use? An observable array. How do I connect that up? All right, let's look at an example. Oh, that's right, that's how that works, you know? So it's not so much about necessarily going in the right direction right out of the start.
Mm-hmm.
It's about getting your bearings
and then just kind of picking something to begin.
Picking something, just go in some direction, right? I mean, don't go off the deep end, don't start coding in a different framework than you intend to, obviously, but just build something. Once you've built something, it'll be so much easier to course correct and change your course towards where you ultimately will end up. So that's a little bit about how I work. I don't know, it may not be for everybody, but that's been useful for me.